Oh, Mcbreen had two daughters, and each one in turn was offered in marriage to James E. O'Byrne. Now Kitty was pretty, but Jane, she was plain. So to make up the differ, Mcbreen would explain that he'd give the best heifer he had in the land as a sort of a bonus with Jane, understand? Now young Kitty would charm the birds off the bush, and that left the lad in a horrid nonplush. Now there's no denying Kitty was remarkably pretty, but I can't say the same for Jane. Still there's not the differ of a price of a heifer between the pretty and the plain. Entirely bothered was James E. O'Byrne. He thought that he'd give the schoolmaster a turn. Said he, to wed Kitty is very good fun. Still a heifer's a heifer when all's said and done. And a girl, she might lose her good looks anyhow, but a heifer might grow to an elegant cow. Ah, but still there's no price for the stock, do you mind? And Jane had a face that the divil designed. Now there's no denying Kitty was remarkably pretty, but I can't say the same for Jane. Still there's not the differ of a price of a heifer between the pretty and the plain. Now the schoolmaster said with a great deal of sense, we'll reduce the two girls down to pounds and pence. At the price of the heifer, and Jane, I'll be bound, we'll come out on the top, be a couple of pound. But still I'm forgetting that down in Glengall, should the cattle are going for nothing at all. So Jim thought that he'd wait till the end of the year, till the girls might be cheaper and stock might be dear. Ah, but when he came for Kitty, she had settled for Mcvitty, and Mcbain had appropriated Jane. So whether there's a differ of a price of a heifer is a matter that he never could explain.